that too. Sure enough, he's the guy out there that was laboring a little bit, but now moves into the corner and comes up with a puck. No one at the point to play it to. Datsyuk has to delay, fights his way free, shoots one, and that knockdown. Rebound, another try. No on that one. Reaching out as Crawford can't get it. Datsyuk rising shot. He scores! Datsyuk wins it in overtime. Well, there's a skirmish at one end. The Red Wings poured over the boards to congratulate Ty Conklin. Only his third start since late October, and Pavel Datsyuk has gotten the game winner.
What a job by Detroit down low. Pavel Datsyuk blown away from Patrick Kane, launching it on goal. You got big bodies down low, Jonathan Erickson, Johan Franzen, loose puck, and from below the icing line, Pavel Datsyuk puts it into the empty net, up and over the sprawled out Crawford. What an effort by Pavel Datsyuk, and look at the big bodies down low. Montador's locked into Franzen. The puck will come loose. Crawford can't glove it. Datsyuk, his feet below the icing line, puts it in the upper part of the net. Oh my goodness gracious, what a goal by Pavel Datsyuk.
And then back at the other end, Pavel Datsyuk finds this loose puck.
Eddie, this is something Mario Lemieux used to be able to do. There are not a lot of guys that can score from there. I know it's an empty net, but nonetheless, and you're bang on, that was too many men on the ice, and Joel Quenneville showed and let everybody know it.
Out of all the chaos, Pavel Datsyuk has connected this year for his 13th goal. An overtime winner and a three-way tie in points for the Central Division lead between the Blues, the Blackhawks, and the Red Wings. Datsyuk at 3:08 of overtime. From Johan Franzen and Jonathan Erickson. Final score in the game. Red Wings 3, Blackhawks 2 in overtime. Stay tuned for the Bud Light post-game show. And remember, the NHL is on the NBC Sports Network Tuesday at 7 Eastern. When it's the Sharks and the Wild. From Chicago, good night all.